In this video, we want to cover several of our markup or drawing tools within Track and Trade. We'll be covering the hand tool, the crosshair tool, the line tool, as well as the multi-line tool. This video is a quick reference guide on how to place these tools on the chart, and it's not meant as an educational video on the merits of the tool itself. I also want to make a special note here that this feature is exactly the same whether we're using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. You'll notice that I'm using the futures version for this demonstration. And the first tool I want to talk about is the hand tool. And the first thing I want you to notice is that the hand tool very simply does exactly as you would anticipate. You hold down the left mouse key and it's going to move the chart in any direction in which you want to move the chart based on the movement of the mouse. We can recenter the tool by coming up here and hitting the center chart tool, and this is going to bring the chart back to the center. The next thing I want to point out is, as long as we have the preferences tab selected and we select any tool on the toolbar, the preferences for that tool will appear as you click on it. So for example, we're going to go into the crosshair tool. We're going to click the crosshair tool. You'll notice that the preferences tab brings up the preferences for the crosshair tool. We left click the mouse and we draw the crosshair tool on the screen, and we place the crosshair tool. Once you place the crosshair tool, you'll notice that in the preferences tab you can change a number of things. You can either turn off or turn on the horizontal or vertical lines. You can also change the font size and make it bold. You can also show the text if you would like. You can snap it, and this is the snap feature that allows it to snap to the individual price bars. And or we can extend. You'll notice that the extend is in here and extends it down into the lower window or the lower panel. And so that is the crosshair tool. To remove it from the chart, we just simply right click on the cross and we come in here and we say delete. The next tool I would like to cover is the line tool. And very simply, to draw the line tool, we just simply hold down the left mouse button and draw the line tool, draw our trend line in there, draw it wherever we want. We release the mouse button and the line tool is complete. You'll notice that the preferences are pulled up. We have the different preferences. We have parallel extensions that we can turn on. We can snap to. Of course, the snap to is what makes it snap to the individual price bars. And the linear extensions, which takes it off the screen in both directions. Let's come back and talk about the parallel extensions. Let's go ahead and turn on three parallel extensions. You'll notice that I have the lock turned on. And as I have that turned on, the lock turned on, as I pull one parallel extension out, all the extensions move at the exact same rate and distance. If I turn off the lock, I can now move each individual pair of extensions individually. Just like that. And so that would be how we use the line tool or the trend tool in Track and Trade. Now we can look at the multi-line tool. As I select the multi-line tool, you'll notice that the multi-line tool preferences appear in the control panel. Now the multi-line tool, very simply, is you click each point that you want the line tool to draw between. So we just left click, go to the next point, we left click, go to the next point, left click, next point, left click, next point, left click. I'm not holding down the left click mouse button. If I held the button down, it would still work, but then I'd have to release and then click again. So I'm just clicking each time I get to the point. Now if I want to terminate the drawing, because every time I continue, the drawing continues, and sometimes it feels like, well, it's stuck to my cursor. The way we stop a drawing on the multi-line tool is we right click to terminate. So if I right click, it stops drawing. That's the termination point. And then we can come over here, and of course we have the same features here. We have the text, if there is any. We can put some text on the line, for example. We have arcs, which we can put around the individual points. We have the snap to, which again allows it to snap to an individual price bar. And we can always show the lines, or we can turn the lines off. Then once the tool is no longer selected, because our always show lines is turned off, if we deselect the tool, the lines go away. To bring the lines back, we can simply click on the tool, say always show lines, it brings them back on the screen. Now to remove the multi-line tool from the chart, all we have to do is right click on it, hit delete, and it is removed from the chart, and we can move on to the next tool.